But first, here's today's alternate Eddie. Breaking overnight, the Boeing strike continues after workers vote to reject the latest contract offer from the company.
We will push for the members' demands as quickly as we can, and we remain on strike.
Who's already voted?
Former President Trump fires up his base while Vice President Harris reaches out to undecided voters ahead of Election Day.
The question in 13 days will be, what do the American people want?
The U.S. confirms North Korean troops are in Russia as the war in Ukraine rides on.
If Russia is indeed forced to turn to North Korea for manpower, this will be a sign of weakness, not strength, on the part of the Kremlin.
Let's start with former President Donald Trump. Two rallies in Georgia yesterday, and they seem designed to appeal to his base. He doubled down on insults. He called Democrats stupid at least six different times and promised his supporters they'd be part of something great if they voted. On the other hand, Vice President Kamala Harris spoke to undecided voters at a CNN town hall near Philadelphia, taking questions about the economy and then responding to reports that Trump had praised Hitler while in office, calling her opponent, quote, unfit and dangerous. Nancy Cordes is at the White House for us to help break all of it down for us. Nancy, good morning to you. So we got these two different events. What do they tell you about the state of the campaigns?
I think what it tells you, Tony, good to be with you, is that this has become a race in its closing weeks that in some ways resembles a normal election and in some ways borders on the surreal. On one hand, we watched Vice President Harris last night get grilled about her policy plans on taxes, on the Middle East, on immigration, and she'll be judged based on how specific, how workable her proposals are on those issues, as any candidate for president should be. On the other hand, you have this larger conversation going on now about just how wedded Donald Trump is to the democratic process in the first place.